Hello, my Christian sisters and brothers out there on the VIP Kid Christian Teachers Facebook group. I've kind of started this little tradition with myself to pray for my bookings and your bookings each week, and a few of you have joined in on that. So this is our frenzy prayer for this upcoming week. And I want to share something with you that I feel God gave me in my prayer time. And you're just going to have to decide if this is for you as well. Now, you know, I often show you my bookings and my schedule, and this is what we pray over. So here's what I have. This week coming up, I'm only half full. That's a bit out of the ordinary for me, except for this month. I've been half full like every week going into the week. And then what the frenzy should be booking this week is the week after. And you can see I don't have a single booking. I am completely empty for the next week. And God really challenged me this week to not pray for my bookings. I am not going to pray for God to fill my bookings. And let me tell you why. This is what he told me. If I really trust him to be my supply and my source, then I just need to trust him and pray that he will take care of it, but to truly trust him. Now let's think about this. Some of us here in VIP Kid Land do this job as a side job. We do it to get some extra money for vacations or maybe to go out to eat every once in a while. Some of us maybe do it to help fund our retirement plan so that we can retire safely and comfortably in the future. Some of us use it to actually pay the bills, to put food on the table, gas in the car, and shoes on the kids. So there's a wide range, and God wants to and is able to bless all of those. But God called me this week to not to offer up my bookings to him and ask him to fill them, but to sacrifice some of my bookings, offer them to him as a sacrifice for some of my Christian sisters and brothers out there for their booking purposes, to teach me a lesson that I should truly trust in him for everything he gives me and not trust my VIP kid bookings, but to also sacrifice some of those. And so this is what he has called me to do. So see my bookings here? I'm changing. God has called me to sacrifice 4 of my slots each week for the next 2 weeks. So I am giving 4 slots this week coming up and 4 slots the week after. I'm just giving those to God. I'm not going to open them back up. I'm not going to worry about them. I'm not going to worry about, oh, that was so much money I could have been making. I am just sacrificing those to God. I'm not going to worry about my regulars. I'm just going to give them up, and I'm going to truly trust in God. And that may be what God is calling you to do. Maybe you're doing this for extra money, and maybe you can sacrifice 1 slot a week. I don't know. You have to pray. You have to figure out what God is asking you to do. Maybe you're one of those that is desperate and you are paying bills with this and you are getting out of debt. And maybe this is how you put groceries on the table in your house. Maybe God's not calling you to. Maybe God's calling you to receive. I don't know. But if you are trusting in this and not this, then we are doing it wrong. And I have caught myself trusting in this, saying, God, I trust you to supply through this. I trust you, God, to take care of my needs through this. And that is not what God is calling me to do. God is calling me to trust him that what he does bring will take care of my needs miraculously. So I'm going to pray for you this week. God, in Jesus' name, Lord, I pray for my sisters and brothers in Christ In Jesus' name, I pray that you would bless them. God, speak to their hearts and call them to what you would have them to do. But God, I do pray for their bookings. I pray that this sacrifice that you've called me to make will bless someone else, and that when someone else who really desperately needs it gets a booking, they will know that it came straight from the throne of the Most High God directly to them as a loving gesture. In Jesus' name, I pray that all would receive blessings from you, but that most of all, we would receive understanding of where our supply really comes from, and it comes from you. All good things come down from the Father of lights. In Jesus' name, help us to settle that in our heart. Thank you, God, for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, trust. Trust and obey. That's what we are called to do. Have a great week, folks.